So you guys, you're basically living next season's trends. I would say both of your characters, you've got the kind of goth vibe going on.
That's
you're
a trend.
Pretty new lad. Do you know about new lad?
No.
This guy's got it all going on. You've got kind of 90s bleached hair, you've got a bit of a sports stripe.
Right.
So did you enjoy wearing those two looks?
Yeah, no, I think what was good fun was to kind of create those looks with our costume designer, Alex, who's just genius. And we kind of wanted to embody this sort of Eastern European look and kind of... And also the kind of gypsy, pulled together kind of like...
They just kind of grab things from stealing kind of from different stands and stuff like that.
And obviously, the both of you, obviously, you've got dark hair now. You've gone blonde again. You've switched in the film. You're blonde, you're dark. Do you think that you're different when you're blonde slash dark?
I'm definitely different. You're always dark. You were wearing a wig.
Yeah.
Mine was
more white hair, though. Sort of silvery white hair. But
yeah, I wouldn't call it blonde. Yeah.
No, I wouldn't call it blonde.
It's like he grayed too
Silver.
Early because he was so fast.
Yeah.
He put so much stress on his body. He grayed. That's
what, so what happens.
That's
right?
What I thought.
Mm-hmm.
I feel different when I have brown hair, for sure. I kind of feel like I'm sexier. I feel like I'm this, like, really exotic creature instead of this blonde girl from Los Angeles.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The kind of beauty look, it's very goth.
Mm-hmm.
It's quite 90s. Was there anybody that you kind of took inspiration from? Were there any films that you watched prior to this that may have inspired you, like The Craft or something?
The whole creation of Scarlet Witch is that she is, like, a shy, darker character, very angry, but also that, I don't know if you spent much time in Eastern European countries, but the style there is always a little dated from where maybe, like, people are in major metropolitan cities.
Mm-hmm.
Like, when I was there, it was, like, the whole rest of, when I was in Russia for school, like, Rastafarian got cool, like, 90s grunge flannels were really cool then.
Mm.
And so we were trying to figure out something that felt dated.
We're bringing it back in the fashion.
Yeah,
yeah, you are. You brought it right back around.
And so that's where that came from. And then also, because I'm not going to be in a leotard and a cape and a headdress to play this character as she is in the comic books, Joss, it was really important for him for there to be a new silhouette, that it's not a bunch of women in pants, that there was a woman, that there was a dress and there was a skirt, and that kind of flow and that actual circular shape was, that was more of the idea behind it. And then the leather jacket is supposed to be, this is something that I took from Black Widow's closet.
When you were younger, did you sort of read comic books and watch that sort of stuff on TV and stuff? And did you grow up kind of wanting to be a superhero or a comic book character at all?
I actually didn't mind being like Robin. I quite liked Robin.
Okay.
Really? That was like the
I think
worst
it was
version
probably
of those
more,
movies, though.
But I think it was like
with
more
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Relatable. Like, I felt like I could possibly be Robin, rather than Batman was way out of my reach.
Right.
Whereas Robin was actually like,
totally
anyone
accessible.
Could be pretty much Robin. So I felt like I could have, that was
that
definitely.
Is so funny.
And at one point, I think
like
he became...
Like, you dimmed your light at a young age.
Like, what, I gave myself the step
perspective,
below.
Perspective, yeah. You're like,
I
have
reach
some perspective.
High, you mean?
I can't be Batman, but I can be Robin.
Well, I knew at an early age what I could be, you know, cast as. Clearly, I obviously knew one day there's still room for those sort of things.
That is so funny.
That's great. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Amazing.